Hello ladies and gentlemen, so this video is all about combinations for poets, okay? To see whether you have this combination to emerge as a poet, okay? Jupiter should be powerful in the second house. In fact, I have made a video on the combinations for professions authors. I told the same thing. Why? Because let me tell you, Jupiter and Mercury are the primary karakas for education, wisdom, knowledge, intellect, creativity, and innovation. So most importantly, Mercury, if at all I'm talking about here on the poets, so Mercury will be holding the first rank in terms of karakas for education and creativity, okay? And the lord of fourth house happened to be Jupiter or Venus or Mercury, and is sitting in their own house, okay? Any zodiac sign for that matter, there has to be fourth house lord, and they should be sitting in the same house. For example, fourth house lord happened to be moon, sorry, fourth house lord happened to be a Sagittarius or Pisces, and they should be staying on the same house. That means fourth house lord should be sitting in the fourth house. This is an indication that this person will be emerge as a poet. And the 10th house is the house of achievements. Okay, the exalted or benefic planets sometimes show greater achievements in the education field or the field of knowledge, as it is through the 10th house that ones receive the recognition. That means if the 10th lord happened to be Mercury, Jupiter or Venus, and they should be staying in the 10th house itself. That means 10th house lord placed in the 10th house. This indicates that that person might emerge as a poet. Okay, in the Navamsha chart, if the Jupiter aspects the 5th house or a 5th lord, one becomes a serious and desirable poet. Okay, so in the birth chart, if Jupiter influenced 5th from the Mercury, one gets the same results. Okay, so Jupiter should be staying in the 5 houses apart from Mercury in your Lagna chart or in the Navamsha chart. That is also an indication that this person might emerge as a poet. Okay, and Sun, Mercury, Venus is placed in the 2nd house. This makes the person poet. Okay, and the lord of Drikkan, that is the lord of D4 chart, the lord of ascendant in the D4 chart, placed in the 5th house of your D4 chart. Okay, let's say the first house in your D4 chart happened to be Libra. The lord of Libra is basically Venus, and this Venus has to be placed in the 4th house in your D4 chart. Okay, if possible, we can even check the D4 chart as well. And Mercury in the 11th house gives keen intellect and the higher education. Okay, Mercury in the 11th house gives the intellect, very good intellect and higher education. Jupiter and Venus are aspecting to each other and is placed in the 5th house or 9th house. That is also another indication that this person might emerge as a poet. Okay, and the benefic planet Jupiter, Venus and Mercury occupying Kendras or Trikonas. That means Jupiter, Venus and Mercury should be in the 1st house, 4th house, 7th house and the 10th house. That is called as Kendras. And also the Trikonas, 1st house, 5th house and 9th house, that is considered as Trikonas. Okay, so and Jupiter placed in a very strong, Jupiter should be strong out of all these 3 planets. Then that is also an indication that this person can emerge as a poet. Okay, and according to Varaha Mihira, okay, he is one of the famous astrologer as well. And what he says is, according to Varaha Mihira, Sun should be in the Virgo, and the planet Sun should be in the Virgo. It can be any house in your birth chart. Let it be 4th house, 5th house, 10th house, 11th house, 9th house, 12th house, anything for that matter. From his perspective, that is from the Varaha Mihira perspective, the Sun should be in the Virgo zodiac sign. Virgo zodiac sign happened to be 9th house for you, 12th house for you, 1st house for you, 2nd house for you. Sun should be placed in the Virgo. If Sun is placed in Virgo, this makes the person very skillful in terms of writing, painting, poetry, philosophy and mathematics. Okay, so that is what he says. And when the lord of 10th house is in the Navamsha chart and is conjunct with Mercury, okay, this person have the very good earning capacity in terms of composing of poems and also by being a writer, astrologer, as per Faladipika. And Mercury and Venus in the 10th house from moon sign is very good for higher education, wealth and good wife. okay? And Sun, Moon and Mercury are placed in the 11th house or the 10th house. This is also an indication that this person might become a poet, okay? I gave you nearly 7 to 8 combinations, alright? So, if at all you book for my astrology consultation, I'll be checking from this angle perspective also. If at all you have question from this perspective, alright, I can able to check. I have so many other combinations. I just gave you very important combinations which we generally check in the birth chart, alright? So, please book for astrology consultation. Once you book for the astrology consultation, it will enable me to check your birth chart for a longer period of time and I can able to provide you the final prediction depending upon the planetary alignment. Alright, so your date of birth, time of birth, place of birth should be accurate in nature. Alright, so thank you so much and I'll see you in the consultation. And also if at all you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click on the bell icon and subscribe button so that you'll be notified for the future videos. And let me know in the comment section what exactly you learned from this video, what exactly you loved from this video. Alright, so thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned for other videos. And in my YouTube channel, I have made so many videos on Vedic astrology, nearly 400 to 450 videos. Please do check those videos also. And let me know in your comment section what exactly you learned from this video so that I know that you are following my videos. Alright, so stay tuned. Bye for now. I'll meet you in the next video.